What's up?
The first value that we are looking at is blood hemoglobin level. 107 hemoglobin is lower than normal. Decrease in hemoglobin concentration we call anemia, and once we see anemia, we have to determine how severe is the anemia and which type of anemia it's according to the size of red blood cells. So how severe is the anemia? In order to tell this, we have to know two numbers. It's 110 and 80. So normal hemoglobin level for male is 130-160, for female 120-140. From 110 to lower limit of normal is mild anemia. From 80 to 110 is moderate anemia, and lower than 80 is severe anemia. So in this case, hemoglobin value is 107, so it's moderate anemia. The type of anemia, according to the size of red blood cells, we determine by MCV. The red blood cells with MCV between 80 and 100 called normocytes, greater than 100 macrocytes, and less than 80 microcytes. In this case, MCV is 90.8, so it's normocytes. So it's moderate normocytic anemia. Usually, when hemoglobin is low, red blood cells are low. And in this case, red blood cells 2.59, which is lower than normal. The next value is platelets. Platelets are 88, which is significantly lower than normal. So now we have to say how severe is the thrombocytopenia. With thrombocytes, we have to know two values. It's 100 and 50. The normal value of platelets is 150 to 400. From 150 to 100, it's mild thrombocytopenia. From 100 to 50, moderate. And lower than 50 is severe. So in this case, it's moderate thrombocytopenia. The next value that we are looking at are white blood cells. As we see, white blood cell count is 95.5, which is very high. So now we have to determine due to which cells we have so elevated white blood cell count. And there are three major possibilities. White blood cells consist of three major group of cells. It's myelocytes, lymphocytes, and blast cells. Myelocytes consist of monocytes, basophils, eosinophils, and neutrophils. The first cells that we are looking at are blast cells, because in normal state there are no blast cells in peripheral blood. And in this case, there are no blast cells in peripheral blood. So now two possibilities left. It's lymphocytes or myelocytes. The next value is lymphocytes. Lymphocytes in this case consist 85% of all white blood cells, which is significantly higher than normal. The state when both white blood cells and lymphocytes are elevated, we call absolute lymphocytosis. As we see, all forms of neutrophils are significantly lower than normal. In addition to this, there are no basophils or eosinophils, and monocytes are on lower limit of normal. In addition to this, we see that there are prolymphocytes in peripheral blood, which is highly unusual because there are no prolymphocytes in normal condition. And also there are smudge cells, or we call them Gumprecht shadows. These cells are basically very old lymphocytes that cannot die. Because they cannot die, and as you know, time has no mercy, they just circulate in this old decrepit state in the bloodstream and become the shadows of themselves. So we see that there is huge absolute lymphocytosis, which is the major criteria of chronic lymphocytic leukemia. In addition to this, there are prolymphocytes and smudge cells, which are also the signature features of chronic lymphocytic leukemia. So it's chronic lymphocytic leukemia that is complicated by moderate normocytic anemia and moderate thrombocytopenia.
Great. Fine. Yep.
Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.